I'm Henny, Mitutoyo's Data Management and Measurlink Sales Engineer, and today we'll be talking about Measurlink Security. Measurlink Security works with the Security Center module, so you may have this installed on one of your client PCs. And if you have security enabled, you should see this login screen here. If you don't, you'll want to contact your Measurlink tech support team, and they'll be able to give you instructions on how to enable it so you can log in and log out to protect certain information. I'll go ahead and add my admin and launch into Security Center. So you'll notice here we got two sides to our screen, the properties window on the right, and then the actual security library on the left, consisting of profiles, users, and permits. What we want to do is we want to start off creating a profile so that we don't have to set individual rights to each user. So we may have a profile for, let's say, the operators or engineers or supervisors, managers, whatever the case is. You can create specific profiles and add users to each of those profiles. So let's go ahead and add a new profile. Let's go ahead and right-click and create new profile. And let's say we're going to have a profile of managers. So under managers here, we can expand and we can see all the different modules that are going to be available on this client. So I can look at real time. I can say, do I want managers to be able to create new runs or delete certain data or any of those sorts of things? The answer might be, yeah, I want to have them to have full access to everything. But maybe I don't want them to have access to Security Center. I'm going to leave that only to an IT profile or whatever the case is. So you can go in and look through each of the module's security settings and block access or allow access to any of those. Once you have a profile created, you'll want to add a user to that profile. Simply, you can go into your Users tab if you've already created a user, and you can drag and drop that user into the profile. What you can also do is right-click on your profile and click New User. So you'll see that the user will show up here on the bottom. I'll go ahead and type in Bob. And now that we've created this user, it's already applied its membership to that profile. And we can see that here that Bob is an active member of the manager. Over here, we'll see all the user information. We can change the user ID. If Bob is no longer with the company, we can deactivate his user, add certain information, idle timeout, changing of password and password attempts, and all of those great things. What you can also do is if you don't want to have to create individual users, let's say you have a large company or you have an IT that supports Windows Active Directory, you can go into any of the profiles and you can add a Windows user that will apply to the Windows Active Directory. So you'll want to go ahead and talk to your IT personnel if your organization supports that. This is a great way to have single sign-on capabilities so the user can just sign into Windows and Measurlink will recognize who that person is and what all their security settings should be. So everything we looked at affects the settings inside of Measurlink. Can they access certain windows? Can they delete certain things or modify data or any of that kind of stuff? But what happens if you have certain parts that you don't want people to have access to? Well, that's why we've created this new function called permits. So let's say, for example, you create parts for commercial and ITAR regulated parts where only specific individuals can see that part information. So what we'll want to do is create a permit so those who have that permit have access to look at those parts. So I'll go ahead and right-click on our permits, click New Permit, and let's use the ITAR example. So I've just created an ITAR part, and now I need to give certain users access to that permit. So I can say, let's see, maybe the admin has access to it. I can go ahead and apply their name to the ITAR part, and we should be good to go from there. Except now we want to apply what is going to have that permit ability. What's going to need a permit? Which part numbers in my organization are going to need that? So I'll go ahead and save that ITAR permit. I'll move over into the support center. And we'll expand our part library, and let's say XYZ2345. let's say this is what we want to have, needing a permit to have access to it. So you'll see in Measurlink version 9, the permits tab, if you don't see this tab, it means you're not on the latest service pack. So you'll want to go to the Measurlink website and download the latest service pack and install that. Go to our permits, and there we see that we have an ITAR permit available. So now XYZ345 requires a permit to be able to see this information. We can see in the design tab that because me as an admin logged in as an admin, I could see all of the characteristics associated to it. So if I go ahead and log out as the admin and I log back in under my user, we'll see what we have access to. So I'll go ahead and log back in. I'll open up my part library. And now I see XYZ345 has this little icon on here. And it shows that I do not have access to the ITAR permit, and therefore I cannot see any of the information associated to this part. You can apply ITAR permits or any permit to any of the folders inside the part library. And there you have it. That's Measurlink Security.